Fajiwara. Well, it is late November. Today's the 24th, and might as well be Christmas. My dad's got a friend who's a designer, and clearly a very talented designer. So the place is glowing with Christmas decorations, literally. The candle is mine. I bought that at Target with Larissa last week, or 2 weeks ago. But all the rest of this is not mine, so... Very festive, as my sister would say. We're enjoying the ambiance here. I'm going to come out here just to be quiet. My dad has already gone to bed. I'm going to give you a quick update on today. We're on the iPhone, so I can't flip this thing around very easily. The E60 is back. I have not yet cleaned the dirty windows, so you won't be able to see very much at all. We'll try. Oh, that window's much better than the other one. It's back. It's running fine. We got everything back together. Regarding the throttle actuators and idle actuators, no more codes. Car runs great, as far as I know, so that's good news. Ordered a few more parts today. A couple of them are already on. The rear BMW roundel badge on the trunk lid was original. I thought we had replaced that. I was wrong. So the trunk lid badge was original, and the clear coat on it was starting to crack. It had all these little cracks in it, looked like shit. So we got a new one of those, new grommets, cleaned the bodywork under the badge. So that's nice and fresh. Thing two, it's hard to show you on an E39 door because the cars are so different, but pre-LCI E60s have a piece of trim that runs right here next to the door handle and window switch panel that is in, you know, the wood or the aluminum. It's called Aluminum Shadow S737A, I think is the option code on that car. And for some reason at the bottom, it's like glued on. It's a really thin piece of aluminum and it was popping up. So I was all clever 2 weeks ago, and I got some glue, like plastic glue, and I pulled the trim out, and I put it in there, and I pressed the trim into it, and then I got like 12 zip ties and went around the whole handle every inch and left it on there for not one, not two, but 3 entire days, and thought, oh, that'll be long enough for the glue to dry. The glue says overnight for full strength. So I cut the zip ties off, and 5 minutes later, pops right back off of the glue and it's loose again. So we tried to remove it today. That bent it. It deformed it. $140. Bob's your uncle. New piece of trim is on the way from Germany. It's 4 weeks out. So that kind of sucks. But it's the way it goes. E60 your interior build quality leaves a bit to be desired. Today's Tuesday. Today was a day of PPIs. We did a PPI on a 2003 330 CI 5-speed titanium silver, 165,000 miles, been sitting since July, needs brakes all around, front tire or front control arms, trans and motor mounts, what else? Seeping transmission, diff output flanges, kind of the normal suspects on an old E46. Thing number two, car number two today was a 2003 M5 carbon black, 96,000 miles, M1 CR interior. That is a full leather luxury caramel interior in stunning condition. The car needed its normal cosmetics, original bumper, never been resprayed. So it needed, would benefit from a fresh bumper. The pork chops are cracked. This piece of the bumper down here at that body line is cracked. So it needed those cosmetics, but mechanically, we found, again, seeping diff output seals. We found leaking power steering lines. It needs motor mounts. It needs trans mounts. It's got a UUC Evo 3 shifter, which rubs the drive shaft and winds. Front thrust arms could definitely stand to be replaced. There's a crack you can almost put your finger in. Rear upper control arms, the lower of the rear upper control arm, or the rearmost of the rear upper control arms. No real problematic codes in any of the computers, which was a nice find. Super, super nice car. Just needs some of the normal cosmetics and then some of the normal mechanical things by 100,000 miles. So I've been writing reports and sending out invoices and that kind of stuff all day. I'm exhausted. I'm going to hit the hay. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow on Wednesday. It's the day before Thanksgiving. So tomorrow kind of feels like a Friday, actually. I'm going to take my car up to the shop, probably do a little wipe down. I need a haircut. I'm going to be packing for an upcoming trip this weekend, which will be fun. And I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Good night.